Yo!
What's up? I'm Adam.
Hey, I'm Jay.
And Jay is joining us because, look, Visual Calcs came out and we need to know what this is all about. And I heard, Jay, you're the person to tell us. Before we get into it, tell us who you are and what you do so people can understand.
Yeah, so I'm a product manager on the Fabric team, and I mostly focus on the programming language that most people love to hate, which is called DAX. So that's what I do.
Amazing. So I'm so happy you joined us for this. Visual Calcs has been kind of a long time coming. I'm super excited it's there. Tell us what Visual Calcs are all about and like why should someone use it?
DAX is hard. So we really started thinking like, what can we do to make it easier, right? You write your measures, and it's always very complicated to think about how that measure is going to be executed in scope of the model. And then we said, well, what if we turn this whole thing upside down? And instead of you requiring to think about that measure inside of the model, you're looking at a visual. You're doing something visually here. You want to add a calculation onto that visual. So what if we allowed you to do just that? And that's what visual calculations are.
Amazing. All right, Jay, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it here in Guiding Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to your machine and take a look.
Okay, so over here, I got my beautiful empty report. So I'm just going to make a very quick standard visualization here. Let me just turn this into a bar chart so it's easy to see. So what I can do now is I can open what we call the visual calculations edit mode. And with that, I can now enter calculations onto this visual. I can actually just start adding a calculation right now. So I've got sales amount over years in here and total product cost. I can actually do something like a running sum maybe. And you know, I want to do a running sum of the sales amount over years. So normally this would take many, many lines of DAX. And in Visual Calcs, this is so easy. I can just type, just say running sum of sales amount. And it works. Now I've got a running sum of sales amount over the years.
What? Wait, right? All you did was hit that add calculation and you just typed DAX and that's it.
Yeah, I typed one word, almost English, right? You can see it. It's running sum of sales. Literally, it's not 20 line DAX, it's not 60 line DAX. It's just one simple, very simple piece of almost text.
Those near English words, like are those new commands that were made specifically for this?
You're still using DAX. You not need to learn a new language. So anything of the normal DAX will still work. But now you really like have this extra capability of Visual Calc specific functions that are, as you said, almost like English, right? You know, if you had a function for sales amount versus the previous year, what would be the function you think you would use? Maybe previous?
Yeah.
Well, that's literally the function that we introduced. Previous, first, next, last. It is so simple now. That's Visual Calcs in a nutshell. There's more stuff that you can do.
Yeah.
You have templates built in, for example. Templates are really a quick way of starting with visual calculations, so you don't have to discover the language on your own. Gene, I have this little FX button over here, and now running sum I already did, so I'm going to skip over that. But you can see there's a template for moving average, or a percent of parent template, a percent of grand total average of children versus previous or versus first. So I can select any of these, and what will happen is we will load the template for you, so you don't have to learn the whole thing from scratch, right? So I can say, hey, you know what? I'm just going to do a comparison between the 2 years. So I'm going to take sales amount minus the previous of sales amount. So what will happen here is for each row, it will take the current sales amount for each year, right? So let's say the 51 million something for 2020. And then it will look at what is the previous sales amount. So that's going to be the 34 million something for the previous year. And it's going to subtract the two. This sounds so simple, but in regular DAX outside of Visual Calcs, referring to what came before me, it's almost impossible. As you can see, I've now got these two Visual Calcs on my visual. Arguably, I mean, I'm not a great visual designer, but even I can see that this visual is not that good right now, right? It's pretty ugly. So what I can do now is I can actually just say, you know what? I'm just going to hide the stuff that I don't need from my visual. So the total product cost, I actually didn't end up using on the visual at all. So I'm just going to get rid of it. And then maybe I wanted to show the sales amount and the running sum. And maybe the versus previous, I don't want to show on the visual right away. So let me just move that to my tooltips over here. You know what? I'm just going to hide sales amount anyway. So the resulting visual I'm going to have is then just the running sum of the sales in years. And then in the tooltip, we're going to see the comparison between the years. So when I'm back out of this, then that's finally my visual. So what I'm doing now is actually these visual calculations are still here and the ingredients that they use are still here, but I now have the ability to decide what I'm going to show on my visual. So this allows me then to make very complicated calculations stepwise, but not show everything just show the end result.
I know there's been discussions about like, okay, we've got these visual calcs now, we can use those in the visuals. Where do you see that boundary of when something should be added to the model versus doing this inside of the visual itself?
Visual calcs are great for those one-off things, like, oh, I just need it for now, this one visual, or for maybe this one or two visuals, or for just this report. I don't want to go extend and bloat my semantic model for this one thing that I need. They're not as reusable as measures. I don't see them also as a replacement for measures. I do see them as a easier to use companion as well. I expect new users to actually find this more attractive and more useful than us throwing them into the deep end, where they have to worry about the complexity of DAX, right? So think about this as a learning curve.
Think about being a data engineer type person. It's like, I don't know any of that.
And that's where Visual Calc really comes in.
Okay, so you showed a lot of cool things. I'm convinced I'm going to start using these. I did look at the docs and I saw a long list of considerations and limitations. Is this something we're going to, you know, you're going to continue to work on and those will go away? Well, it'll be improved, or what's the story there?
No, absolutely. We're not even close to being done. In fact, we just started on this. We've started publicly on this. We're still working. We already made a lot of changes based on the feedback that we already got. And yes, those limitations, most of them will go away over time. And we need you to give your feedback on this, right? As I said, we are just embarking on this journey. It's a long journey. I would like to ask everybody to just jump in right now and tell us, hey, what do you think? What's okay? What's great? What is not so great? I would like to learn from that.
All right. And we'll have that link down in the description as well, so you can go check that out. This is your opportunity to go tell Jay what could make this better for you. All right, Jay, I appreciate it so much. Thanks for being here. If you guys have any comments or questions in addition to this, you know what to do. Leave it in the comments below and we will try to do our best to answer those for you. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.